I must apologize for being late today because we were under a wrong impression. We are today facing a new type of problem within our lives, which in the olden times people did not face. Most of them did not think of it. Very few thought of it. They were contented people with their ignorance. And they did not bother to find out what is beyond us. Perhaps that time we were trying to develop ourselves materially. We are trying to build our tubes and our trains and our hospitals. But when that is all over, a new seeking starts in the being, the nature of which is an urge. But what we are seeking, we do not know. It's the first time such an urge starts. Before this, we had an urge, say, to eat our food. We knew we were hungry, we have to eat. Or we wanted some shelters, we wanted to build our houses. We wanted comfortable life, we wanted to build our great civilizations, you can say, of affluent countries. But all those wants, very well known to us, we could plan about them, think about them, were all right till we reached a certain stage of evolution. Suddenly we got exposed to a new urge within us, which wanted to know something of the beyond, which was really of the beyond. Because whatever is of the beyond is not conceivable from this end. It cannot be understood, one cannot plan about it, one cannot think about it, but you feel that dearth, or you can say that kind of a gap within yourself, which forces you to seek something. And great seekers were born in the West or in the East. Today I am facing you, I am with you. So for all practical purposes, I am a Britisher and a Western person. Because we have to face the problem as we are. This urge within us comes from something we have known before. And that is the urge which is given to us from our evolutionary process. We know about our evolution, that we have become human beings from chimpanzee, as they say, or maybe from amoeba we have risen to this state, that we have come up to this state, that we feel that we are human beings today. And at this stage, after the evolution, when we have finished with the so-called urges of our material wants and our mental wants, you can say in Oxford University, naturally we wanted to read and know things and science and development. And also many of our physical wants being completed, or sort of we being satisfied about them. Now at this stage of evolution, we are thinking of something else, a gap. There's a void. We feel the void within our lives. The nature of that is vaguely described, that we are seeking our wholesomeness. Some people say that we are seeking our absolute. Some are saying we are seeking our meaning. Some say, what is the point of living like this? Now, I have had people of different types and different styles, and the expression that they give is of this kind of vague attitude towards their seeking. But there is a kind of a seeking which is making them so depressed and so frustrated that they are willing to do anything to get to it. They have done all kinds of experimentation. For example, drugs, most of them have done it out of seeking only. I do not blame them because it was just seeking. They have gone to gurus, they have gone to other places, they have read a lot, all kinds of books, whatever is to be read or not read, they have read all kinds of books, sorted it out, and found it was useless, so thrown away. All this has happened, and then we start thinking, is there any sense in this kind of seeking? Before you, when I am sitting and I'm telling you about something of the beyond, you have to take a very scientific attitude. Scientific in the sense that you have to keep your mind very open. And that it is a hypothesis I'm putting before you, which if proved, you should give it a full chance to be proved and then accept. Because here I'm speaking about the statutes of divine laws, not of scientific laws, of divine laws, of divinity within us, the spirit within us, and whether it is there or not. It is for you to experience. And by any brainwashing, it is not going to be experienced. Neither by giving false certificates it can work out, nor if I tell you, you change your dresses, shave your heads or stands on your heads, all these outside things are not going to work it out. Because you must know that you have become a human being without doing anything about it. But we have taken ourselves so much for granted that we don't bother to even know how it must have happened. What must be the force that must have worked it out that today we are human beings? There must be something, some sort of a force within us which must have brought forth this evolution within us. So we have before us a chart. Now, this again is a hypothesis. You need not accept me at all, but you need not deny me, because you are here to receive something. I'm here just to give you something which you can yourself see and receive it. There is no compulsion of any kind, and there is no conviction of any kind. It is something that is of a living nature, evolution, your evolution. The evolution has to take place still within us to know ourselves. We can say that unless and until it is put to the mains, it has no meaning. Unless and until we are connected with the whole, we have no meaning. And is there something within us which really connects us to that? Is there any sense that is written in the scriptures, like Christ has said, you are to be born again? Is there any such happening that takes place among human beings? Because it is said that a Brahmin is a person who is twice born. A Brahmin is called a twice born, and a bird is also called a twice born. Now, a bird is born first as an egg and then as a bird. But how a human being is twice born, that we'll have to see ourselves. If it is so, if it exists, let us face it. The trouble is, we must learn to face it. It is such a tremendous reality. And we, with our knowledge, whatever we have, with our rationality, cannot see it. You have to go beyond this rationality that is so limited. Like if I have come my car. I have to leave my car outside to enter inside this hall. It is something based, I would say, on the spacecraft style. For example, in a spacecraft, you have many cylinders put one into another. And the lowest cylinder, we can say, is the cylinder which is just the matter or the physical being. And then inside are placed other cylinders like the mental being and the emotional being and the spiritual being. When the cylinder moves, or you should say the spacecraft moves, the lowest one blasts the rest of it, by which it gives it a speed which is in a multiple proportions from which it has started. Then the second one explodes, then the third one explodes. In the same way, today, at this stage, you have to be exploded into that last space where you have to reach. It is something on those lines the whole evolution works out. Now within us, as you can see here, I'm saying that you keep your mind open, not to accept anything that I say, but to see for yourself if it works out. If it does not work out, that's not my fault by any chance, because it has worked out with many, many, many English people, and with many, many Swiss and French people also. But it has worked out much more in India, because Indian villagers are very simple people. They are not so complicated. They did not have the ramblings of the rationality. They have not gone into too much of thinking and planning. And that's why I find that Indian villagers are very well suited for Sahaj Yoga, because they are very simple people and they get the realization in thousands. It's changing the complete face of our Indian villages, because people are transforming very fast with it. Now within us is placed that connection in the triangular bone, which is called as the Kundalini. She is coiled in 3.5 coils for some mathematical relationship, which I'll tell you later on. And she sleeps there, as they call it, because there are no words to say about your awareness, what it does, but they say it sleeps. And when awakened by some authorized person, she ascends through those 6 centers which are shown here. Can you show someone? Just show the 6 centers. And 6 centers. The 7th is out of question. The 6 centers. In Sanskrit it is called as Shat Chakra Bhedan. From first, First is left. First, then second. Start from Swadhisthana, yes. First, then second, then third, then fourth, and fifth, and sixth. Now these subtle centers reside within our spinal cord and in our brain. Now when you see these 3 powers, the first power, which is in blue color, is the power of our desire, of our existence. It is expressed outside in the gross as left sympathetic nervous system. The right hand side power, which comes to you, is called as the power of action, Kriya Shakti, and is expressing itself outside as the right sympathetic nervous system. The central channel is called in Sanskrit language as Sushumna Nadi, but it is very partly developed into human beings and is known as parasympathetic nervous system. Our growth, that will do, thank you. Our growth within has been up to a point that we are human beings, and our awareness has been up to the same point as we are human beings. Whatever we feel on our central nervous system is the achievement of our evolution. And whatever we have not yet felt has to be achieved. Now what do we have to achieve by this ascendance or by this
Kundalini awakening. What are we expecting? Why Kundalini awakening has been kept there as the last thing that should happen in our evolution? As I said, that is like the cord which connects you to the mates, to the subtle, to the whole, to the universal unconscious. This Kundalini is the residual force which is waiting for a moment when some authority on the subject, not in the theological college, but from the divine, a person who is a realized soul and who has knowledge how to raise the Kundalini, can only raise it. It's a spontaneous process. It is effortless. Like a seed, if you have to sprout it, you cannot pull it out, the primule out of it, and sprout it. It has to work out spontaneously. In the same way, this Kundalini, when it finds the atmosphere congenial for its awakening, it rises. It passes through these centers, and these centers are the landmarks of our evolution. Now, when you see that green center, which is called as the Nabhi Chakra, which in the gross expresses your solar plexus, is responsible for your evolution. This center has created you out of a carbon atom into amoeba and then to human being. This center is, again, very, very important. When this center becomes extremely powerful, then you get the higher urges of receiving higher heights in your awareness. Now, what do we have to become? We have to become the whole. You must have read Jung and you must have read all these people who has talked about the universal unconscious, that there is universal unconscious, that there is an all-pervading consciousness which exists in every person, which is subtler than our consciousness. If we can touch somehow or other that consciousness, we can become aware of that universal unconscious. Jung has said that he has experimented with dreams of thousands of people, and he was amazed that in the dream, the same universal unconscious throws symbols which are very significant and absolutely universal in nature. For example, a person is to be murdered. Then he sees a particular type of a triangle in a particular angle. And if such an angle appears, then one must know that there is some indication coming to him that he is going to be murdered. But if he is going to murder someone, the same triangle appears in the opposite direction. He has verified it with thousands and thousands of cases and has said there is universal unconscious working. Now we have scriptures on the other side, which says that you are to be born again, you are to be baptized. Of course, people think by going to church you can be baptized, you can understand that's not possible. But you can be baptized through somebody who is a realized soul. And that also, we have so many other proofs of saying that one has to be beyond, like medical sciences, if you take. In the medical sciences, they say that we can manage the sympathetic nervous system. But the parasympathetic nervous system, we cannot control. It is autonomous. What is auto? Who is auto? Who is controlling your heart? Supposing you want to run fast, you can increase the rate of your heart. But who can decrease the rate of your heart? Who does that? And they say it is autonomous. It is like saying something unknown and give it a name, finished. Autonomous nervous system, by saying auto, they at least accept that there is someone who is controlling the heart of which we are not aware. Now, there is something more than that. For example, a fetus is contained in the uterus. Now, it is said that any foreign matter that enters into the human body has to be expelled. But it is retained. Not retained, but it is nurtured. Not nurtured, it is expelled at the time when it is ready to go out. Who does that? Christ has said, those who are not against me are with me. Who are they? There are many things like that, many, many things like that, which human beings have not been able to answer. Now before you, I say that there is the all-pervading divine power. It exists. It is the most dynamic power which acts in every particle of this universe. When you see a sulfur dioxide vibrating, you must know that it is done through this power. Nothing moves without that power. It has got a special power by which it can communicate, it can control, it can love. And this power you can achieve through your Kundalini awakening. There is no other way out. Sprouting of the seed has to be done through the sprouting. There's no other way out. And this has to work out within you. I mean, on this subject, one can go on speaking for hours together. I must have spoken, I don't know, 200 times at least in UK. And so far, they say that still, Mother, you have to speak about this subject and that subject. So the knowledge is vast, but by getting realization, you become one with your spirit, one with yourself. And the spirit is the knowledge, is the joy, and is the bliss. You have to achieve that state of self-realization. By self-realization, what happens to you? First of all, when Kundalini rises and crosses over this center here, what happens? You become thoughtless. But you are aware, absolutely aware. Between the two thoughts, there is a gap. And when you pass through that gap, then your attention becomes silent. There is no thought coming to you from the ego and the superego. The yellow stuff is the ego and the left side blue stuff is the superego. No thought comes from your attention, from your past or from the future. You just become silent. But it does not happen to everyone. It doesn't happen to people who are superficial, those who are just seeking because of fashions. It doesn't happen to people who think no end of themselves, who are full of ego, whose ego like a balloon is covering their head and their heart. It doesn't happen to people who are full of superego, who are possessed. It doesn't happen to many people who are sick, who have got problems of the body, problems of the mind. But they can be corrected, they can be cured, and it can happen. As a result of this, diseases like cancer also get cured. We have cured cancer in your country. We have cured cancer in India. Cancer can only be cured through Kundalini awakening. If you do not get your Kundalini awakened today, you are making cancer every day within you. Every minute the cancer is established. And once the Kundalini is awakened, the exhaustion of your energy, the overuse of your sympathetic nervous system is brought to balance, and all the time there is the flow of the vital energy within you, and you feel absolutely blissful, joyful, and that energy then starts flowing through your hands when the Kundalini pierces through your fontanel bone area called as Talu, Sahasrara. Is called as the Brahma Randra, means the hole to the Brahma. Brahma is the all-pervading power. When it pierces that, then only you will find the cool breeze flowing from your hand, which is described by Adi Shankaracharya as Chaitanya Lahari. It is described by In the Bible, it is described as the breeze of the Holy Ghost. You start feeling your own spirit manifesting that cool breeze from you. And when this starts flowing, you start feeling them differently on different fingers. Now, they have shown there how on these fingers you have different colors, the same colors which are in the centers. We have now here five fingers, six and seven. These are the seven centers within us. And all these centers get enlightened. Then you start feeling yourself on these centers and you start feeling others on these centers at the very outset. You start feeling which is the problem. Now supposing I put my hand on someone and I get a sort of a pain or sometimes a little burning on this finger. This finger relates to the left side, that is the heart. And such a person must be having a problem with the heart in some way. But if this finger is combined with this finger, then such a person is full of ego. And if such a person is full of ego, his heart is gone into the balloon of the ego. But because of realization, you start seeing it within you. Then you don't feel bad. You yourself say, Mother, my ego, please put it down. It's colossal. You yourself start seeing your problems because you have got out of your own outside self. You start seeing it so clearly. You start knowing them, cleansing them. Once you have established your self-realization, you become a person who is called as nirvikalpa, means doubtless. He becomes that. And from your hand, you can raise the kundalini of people. It is so fantastic that unbelievable. People cannot believe it. It is too fantastic. But the fantastic times have come. For example, if you take a television to a place where people have never seen a television, and you tell them that there are lots of pictures around and you can see them, they'll be quite surprised. How can that be? But as soon as the television is put to the mains, you can see those fantastic pictures. And this is what happens. This is exactly what happens to you. Because you are the instrument made for this specialty. You are the one who has to become that instrument. Your fulfillment is in becoming that, in knowing that. It is not a thing which can be just told or could be read about. It is an experience. It has to happen. If it does not happen, it does not happen. You cannot force anybody. You cannot say it has happened. It is not possible. For this experience, God has created you. And all of you have to get this experience. Otherwise, you'll be left behind in evolution. And you can never be happy. There are many who do not bother about it. They do not even have any seeking in this world. There are so many who have no seeking, very superficial people. But they all have to come now. But there are also very ardent, real seekers. I have found them. So many of them are real. And once we establish them, I'm sure many others would join. It's a slow process because it is a living process. You can create as many as you want plastic flowers, but to create one flower, you have to wait. But once the blossom time comes, many can get realization, and it is happening in many places that en masse realization has worked out. In America, and other places it works out. Two persons came from Australia, and now I'm getting letters from them that they have given realization to at least 100 people in Australia. It's most surprising that they themselves have given realization to 100 persons. It's very much encouraging that the world is today ready to receive it and they are seeking it. I do not know how far I should go and how much I should say, but I would like to have some questions from you. It would be a good idea because this is a place of the university and must be some intellectual sitting here. And I would like to answer their inquiry about Kundalini if they have to ask me. Any question, I'll be very happy to answer. It's just an introduction.
Well, I see this chakra open up here on the person. I've seen the white light on kind of my forehead, but I can't bring the energy back. How it should be, how it should flow.
What is he?
He's saying he's had an experience
of the light here. You see, yes, that is a short circuiting. That is a short circuit. Your light has to come from here. There is nothing that you see, you become something. It is not perceived through these senses of perception like seeing or hearing. Actually, when the kundalini rises, you might see some light. You might also get some fragrance, maybe. But the best kundalini is that which doesn't see anything, just goes straight forward. Supposing you are going to the airport, you may see some light, you may see something on the way. But what is the main thing is that you have to achieve at the airport, isn't it? On the way, whatever you say has no meaning. But you may see. But some people just do not see anything, just they get it. They are just there. The best aeroplane is that which lands most smoothly. This is what is the kundalini. The persons should get the minimum of minimum obstructions on their way, and then they get the kundalini rising so smoothly. Suddenly you find, oh, you are there, you've got it. It works. But can be. There could have been such an experience is a short circuiting. It is due to short circuit. And also some people have described, I have seen some people such big books writing about kundalini, that it burns you when you start shouting and jumping and this and that. It is all unauthorized behavior. Because supposing you do not know about electricity, you put both your fingers in the plugs and you get the shock. And then you say, the electricity, I know it gives you a shock. It's something like that. It's very, I should say, naive attempt. Because you have not known what is kundalini. She's your mother. She's not going to trouble you. She's been waiting and waiting and waiting for ages and years together. So many lives. And now, when the time has come, do you think she'll trouble you? She's there to give you the greatest blessings of life. All right? Any other question, please? No thinking. Thought has gone out. Your kundalini has crossed. You cannot think also. Very difficult. Because kundalini has risen of many people. You cannot stop your thinking while being aware. Any question? Must ask some questions to me. I don't know what to say. It's such a wide subject. Isn't it? It's a very wide subject. All right. It's a nice thing that there are no questions. That means it's working out itself. Now, you have to do a very simple thing. First of all, you have to take out your shoes because we are using the earth to suck our problems also. She does suck. Take out your shoes. Just like this, in a most relaxed manner. Not to cross your feet or to just sit like this. There's nothing to be frightened. We have had thousands of people getting realization and they have been cured. The other day I had a great miracle. A lady had come to see me on a wheelchair in a very bad condition about 8 days back. And I told her, 8 days back did she come? When did we have our program? No. Thursday we had, Thursday. She came on Monday. Thursday she met me there. And Thursday I said, all right, you put your hand in this and that. Can you imagine? She came on Monday walking, just walking. And I saw her sitting down there. I mean, I was rather surprised. I looked at her. I said, are you there? She said, yes, very well. And she got up. I mean, it worked that quick with her. I mean, it can work that quick. Now, another lady I know of her who was absolutely dead because doctor said that she's dying, you better prepare for her funeral. They'd taken, removed all her oxygen and everything. And that is the time when her grandson, who is a Sahaja Yogi, said, mother, you must come and bless her at the last moment. I said, all right. Now, if you say, I don't go to the hospital because my job is not to cure people, but to give realization. As a byproduct, they get cured. That's different. I went there, she was in coma, absolutely in coma. And there she is. I saw her also yesterday there, walking into the hall. I don't know if you saw her, Ajibai. She came, and then she went away. I was amazed. But, I mean, I saw her before that. She got cured, she went to India, and the other day she came for the program. So, all these things can happen. This is nothing so great. The greatest thing is to become yourself when all your powers start manifesting. You people can also cure and give realizations to others. That's how it is going to work. One light, which is enlightened, can enlighten another light, and the same light then can enlighten another light. Like that it goes on. Just put your hands like this, just like this, in a simple way. Put both the feet straight on the ground. Aap log joota aise pair aise rakhe. Please keep your feet like this. Yes. With Indian people always it is so. It's very difficult. You remember one lady we had, she was so rude. They have no value for their own knowledge. Not at all. That's why they come here. Just think of it. This is very common. We went to Wales. On my way I came to Oxford also. There was one Indian lady. And she started arguing about something so badly. There were some very good Indians also. They felt very ashamed. And they said that, you see, these women have come from India without any idea as to what they have to do. And I said, all right. And all the time she was disturbing me. All the time. Just put your hands like that. Sorry. Put your both the feet on the ground. It's very cold. Working. Close your eyes now. Close your eyes, please. Please put your hands like this, all of you. Please. What does it take to put your hands? After all, you have come here to get your realization. Even this much is not possible. Just put your hands. Now, as a mother, I would say, be a nice boy. Come along. Put your hands like this. Are you putting your hands like this? Just close your eyes. Those who are hungry will get it. Those who are not will be thinking still what to do, what not to do. See, left is more. It's got it. You see? Rishinya, just see them also there. Tell her. All of them. What about you? Close your eyes, please. Close your eyes. It is going to work. Just close your eyes. EGO. Good. The another one also. Most of them have. This gentleman with the... Are you getting cool breeze in the hand? What's happening in the hand? It's tingling. Is it? Good, good, good. Very good. Just put your hands like this. It's going to work out. This gentleman has got it already. Close your eyes. It's going to work out. Give some time to yourself. Please, please. Just give some time. It will work out. Down there. Agya. My left is surprisingly an educational thing. Just get me the light. Surprisingly left. Just see them, I don't know what to just put them. Better. If you have started feeling cool breeze in the hand, you will also feel cool breeze coming out of your head on top. Better now? It's moving? Work it out.
If there is shaking in the hand, then keep your eyes open. If there is no shaking, then please keep your eyes closed. If you cannot close your eyes, then there's something wrong. Please close your eyes. Please do not watch others. Watch yourself. Today is the time to watch yourself. You have been watching others all your life. Why not watch yourself for a change? When are we going to see ourselves and face ourselves? We have been just looking at other people, never at ourselves.
Do not think about it. It has happened to you, so just keep it at that point. Do not think about it. Allow it to work out nicely so that it is established within you.
Who is that girl in the black? You'll gradually see in the first person. Shaking very much. She's a left side problem, I think.
Thanks. Didn't happen? Come along, come here. Come, I'll see. Let him go there. He could not even keep his eyes shut for 5 minutes. So what can he go do it? Have you got cool breeze in the hand? Yeah? Are you feeling any cool breeze in the hand? Huh? Which one? I don't. Really? You get cool breeze? Good. You've been meditating according to what? Huh? Who taught you the mantra? Which one? Now go at the back, please, Jesse. You wear your socks. Better wear your socks, it's very cold. Are you getting cool breeze there? These people also, ask them. But sometimes you get it, sometimes you lose it. Or always you get it. Only when you meditate, then. Something shows that you are a realized soul, but you are not there fully. All right? You should get it all the time. That's the point. Huh? What's it? That's it, I think. You see, because you need not have gone to anyone to ask for anything. You had it yourself. By going to them only you are caught up here, and that's how it only comes when you are meditating, when they are you are yourself. And otherwise it goes out, because the problem is there at the back. You feel the heaviness? See? That's it. That is it. That you have acquired. Ray. What did they say? See you later. When? Yeah, when they will have their cancer on. Really? No, I'll tell you what. I told you the thing, what as was is, that you getting your cool breeze is a good thing. It means you might have been a realized soul, a born realized soul, you see. But because you went to all these people, you're caught up here very badly. It's very heavy here. And that's why also you're wearing specs. Huh? That's it. Because you catch here at the back, you see. And you caught it. Because if you are a realized soul, you must know how to keep it up, how to give realization to others, and you must also know the whole technique about it. Any realized soul, now these boys are realized. If they go to anyone like that, immediately they'll have a catch here, or a catch in the heart, or a catch somewhere. Immediately they know. That's what happened with you. So now you learn the whole science of Sergio, and absolutely clear out yourself. It's better. You have to know that. The pardon? What's it? Wisdom? The pardon? Mind is always there. I didn't follow. Throw away. Somebody saying like that. What is somebody saying with it? You felt that it was like an auto-suggestion working? It cannot work out that way. You see, when you suggest to someone, you can put them into a trance, but not in awareness. Not in awareness, you know. In awareness, it won't work out. That's only in mesmerism people do it, with open eyes and things like that.